So today we are going to discuss instruction set of 8085 microprocessor. So at the initial stage, first we will discuss 8-bit data transfer instructions, 8-bit data transfer instructions. Screen is visible or not? MS Word screen is visible or not?
Visible, sir.
Okay, fine. So today's first topic is 8-bit data transfer instruction. Okay. So our first instruction for today's class is, I'm changing color here so that you can easily distinguish between heading and the concept. Our first instruction is move, okay, RD, comma, RS. Here, what is RS? What is RS?
Sir, source
register. And what do you understand by RD?
Destination register.
Destination.
Exactly, this is the correct answer. Here, suffix D represent the destination and the second suffix S represent source. So RX is a source register and the RD is a destination register. In last class, we have discussed about the 8 concept, that is name, function, addressing mode, flag register, IWS, machine cycle, T state, format. So we will discuss every concept one by one. So before I start my topic, can you tell me what is the function of this instruction? What is the function of this instruction? Move RD, RS.
Source destination move karna.
Sorry? I'm not getting what are you saying, beta. Can you repeat your answer?
किसी डेटा को सर सोर्स से डेस्टिनेशन मूव करना.
राइट. कंटेंट ऑफ. एनी अदर आंसर?
सर कंटेंट ऑफ आरएस.
कंटेंट ऑफ आरएस. राइट. आगे.
सोर्स रजिस्टर मूव इनटू द रजिस्टर ऑफ डी. रजिस्टर डी.
ओके फाइन. एनी अदर आंसर? Students, any other answer from your side?
Contents of RS is being transferred to the contents of RD.
Exactly. The content of register RS is moving into the RD register. Or you can say copy of it, basically copy the content of RS into RD register. Okay. And the content of RS will not affect. Can you write this function in your notebook?
RS ke content jab RD mein transfer honge to RS empty nahi hoga na?
No, RS will not be empty. Suppose if we are having 02 in RS register, but after transfer of data from RS register to RD, right? In that case, the value of RS, or you can say RS is stored 02, it will not be affected, it will not be changed after transfer of data, right? Am I audible?
RS mein koi bhi effect nahi aayega transfer karne.
No, there is no effect in RS during data transfer, even after that data transfer.
Sir,
no pre-post effect in RS. It's a generalized representation. RS is, this RS and RD is any register. A, whether it is A register, whether it is a B register, whether it is a C, D, E, H, M, anything. Right? Okay. Now, my question is, what is the IWS for this instruction? IWS. Instructions word size for move RD, RS. What is the value of IWS? Can you tell me?
What is one the size? Bit.
Eight, one byte, one, right? One the byte. Size of IDO instruction word size is 1 byte, right? Right answer. Now, as you have asked me about the data effect, or whether it affects the data of RS or RD, so let's have a one problem question. I'm giving you one problem. If we register is having a data that is 93H, where H represent hexadecimal format, and the B register having another data that is 69H. Okay. So now I'm writing one program in assembly language that is move A comma B. Move register A comma B. Then after the execution of this program, after the execution of this statement, what will be the state, what will be the status of register A and register B? What will be the status of register A and register B? Okay. Register A and register B. You can write here status or the value. Both are same. Either you can write status or either you can write value. After the execution of this statement, what will be the status of register A and B?
Sir, register B par to affected kuch nahi hoga.
Ek second beta. My screen is visible or not?
Visible, sir.
Okay, fine. Actually, I'm typing in MS Word. If it is not visible, you can tell me. Okay, now give me the answer. What will be the status of register A and B after execution of this statement move A comma B?
So B se A mein transfer ho kare.
Okay, fine.
B par koi farak nahi padta. B ki value wahi rahegi.
The content of register B is transferred into register A, and the value of register B remain unaffected.
Same.
Unaffected, right?
Unaffected, we will, sir.
Here we will not speak constant or any other. So we have to talk only technically. Okay. We will say unaffected. Okay. If it is affected, if it is changed, you will say changed. If it is affected, then you will say it is affected. Okay. Otherwise it will remain unaffected. So can you tell me the value of what will be the value of register A and what will be the value of register B? What is the value of register A and what is the value of register B after the execution of this single statement move A comma B?
93H
in both the register.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This is the perfect answer. The content of register B is 93, and after the execution of this instruction, the data that is 93 is moving into register A. So B register having already 93, now we are copying the same data into register B. That's why both the registers having the same data, that is 93. Okay. Understood?
Yes, sir.
A ke paas apna bhi to data hai, sir. 69.
Because after the execution of this instruction, the data which is already having by register B is replaced by 93. Are you getting my point?
If at 16, the initial 69 H kahan jayega sir fir wo?
It is replaced by 93. Okay, this is the initial stage where register A contained 69 and register B contained 93. Okay, but after the execution of these instructions, B having 69 and the content of register B is move into register A. So the data of A is replaced by 93. And the existing, or you can say past data of register A is 69, but it is now replaced by 93 after the execution of this instruction. Okay.
Yes,
Can
sir.
you proceed further? Okay. I'm giving one more problem so that I think it is not clear to one student. So I'm giving one more problem. Same question. Same problem. Okay. I'm just changing the statement little bit. If register A having 29 and the statement is like this, move M comma A, then what will be the content of register A?
29, sir.
Then what will be the content of register A? Any other answer other than 29? I'm saying if register A having 29 and after the execution of this assembly language instruction, that is move M comma A, what is the status of accumulator? Are you getting my question? Am I audible?
It's audible, sir.
Okay, fine. Now tell me the answer. Are you getting my question? Dinesh, to Dinesh? Dinesh? Mohammed Kamran? Rajkumar Sharma?
Yes, sir.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir, audible, sir.
Kamran, what will be the value of register A after the execution of this instruction?
Sir, 29, sir.
Exactly.
Yes, sir.
After the execution of this instruction, the value of accumulator is 29. What is the function of this instruction? Move M comma A.
Sir, can you?
What is the function of move M comma A?
Sorry.
Accumulated memory.
Sir, memory mein move ho jayega, sir. Copy ho jayega.
Right. After the execution of this instruction, the content of accumulator is moved into memory, and memory here is represented by M.
M.
So this is all about this instruction. Now you tell me, what is the addressing mode in this instruction? Move RD comma RS. Move RD comma RS.
Register transfer, sir. Register.
What is the addressing mode?
Register addressing.
In this instruction. Any other answer? Any other answer?
No, sir.
Okay, fine.
Addressing mode.
This is not the correct answer. Okay. Because here we have taken RD and RS as a generalized representation. If the value of, I'm making two cases, this is case one for addressing mode, and this is case two. Everybody focus here. Small difference for the identification of addressing mode. If the value of RD and RS here is A, B, C, D, E, and H. If
the indirect order, sir.
We are talking about case one. If the value of any register, where the either it is RD register, whether it is RS register. Okay. If value of RS is A, B, C, D, E, H. Either A, either B, C, D, E, or H. Right. And either it is and the value of RD is either A, B, C, D, H. In that case, it is a register addressing mode. Are you getting my statement?
Yes, sir.
If both the register RD and RS having, wait, I'm just selecting here. If the value of RD and RS register is either A register, either B or C, D, E, H, out of these six register is any one of here instead of RD, instead of RS. In that case, this become a register addressing mode. But in case if either RD either RS is M, in that case it is a register indirect addressing mode. A register indirect addressing mode. Okay. The case one is register direct addressing mode. Are you getting? If you have any doubt, you can ask. I'm just writing complete here. Register. This is register addressing mode. The second is register indirect addressing mode. Okay.
The second case में ABC के साथ M भी तो हो सकता, मतलब और भी हो सकते हैं उसमें register.
One second. Ask me your doubt, beta.
सर इनडायरेक्ट होने के लिए आर एस एम होना जरूरी है.
अब देखो दोबारा से, यहाँ पे हमने आर डी एंड आर एस लिया है बेटा, इट्स अ जनरलाइज्ड रिप्रेजेंटेशन. अगर यहाँ पे आर डी आर एस की जगह कोई सा भी रजिस्टर है, ए बी सी डी ई एच, इनमें से कोई सा भी रजिस्टर है एक्सेप्ट एम, ठीक है, एम नहीं होगा यहाँ पे, कोई सा भी रजिस्टर होगा, इन दैट केस इट इज ए रजिस्टर एड्रेसिंग मोड, ठीक है. अगर यहाँ पे सेकेंड केस है आर डी आर एस, इनमें से कोई सा भी एक एम हो गया, वो क्या हो जाएगा, रजिस्टर इनडायरेक्ट एड्रेसिंग मोड, ठीक है. सपोज करो यहाँ पे बी है और यहाँ पे आर डी इज बी एंड आर एस इज एम, इन दोनों में से कोई सा भी एक अगर मेमोरी है तो क्या हो जाएगा, रजिस्टर इनडायरेक्ट एड्रेसिंग मोड, राइट. यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? अंडरस्टूड?
यस सर.
Now we are moving towards the next instruction, second instruction, that is MVI R. For register, I always use R, and for memory I always use M. So while I will using this R, that means I'm using here any register. It's a generalized representation. MVI R. 8-bit data. Now, what is the IWS for this instruction? MVI R 8-bit data.
8.
Can you tell me what is the IWS for this instruction?
Two byte.
Why this is 2 byte?
One for MVI.
Right, and second one byte for 8-bit data.
Eight bit data.
So one yeah. plus one, it become a 2-byte data. So IWS for this instruction is 2 byte. Okay. So now my question is, if I'm replacing here this R is replaced by A B C D E H and M. This R may be a register B or C or D or E or H or M. Okay. What is the addressing mode in this instruction? Can you tell me?
Immediate addressing mode.
Exactly. Because if opcode has last character I,
sir,
then number given in unit will be data. The second thing is, when the last letter of opcode is I, in that case there will be an immediate addressing mode. Okay. Understood?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let's have one problem. I'm just directly writing problem here. you have to tell me the status of the register. MVI A, comma 69H. The second statement is move B, comma A. Now, after the execution of this program, what will be the status of register A and register B? What is the value of register B? 69H. Are you getting this point? Yes sir. Any doubt? Still, if you have any doubt, you can ask. Now I'm changing this code little bit. First instruction is MVI A, 69H. Second instruction is move B, comma A. And the last instruction is hard. Right? Now, what is the status of register A and register B? What is the status of register A and register B?
Sir, register A ki value 69H hogi aur register B ki bhi sir 69H hogi sir.
Unaffected hogi sir.
Unaffected rahegi, right? The values will remain same. Okay. Can we proceed further?
Can you proceed further? Addressing mode implicit hoga. Right. Immediate hoga.
Yeah. And what is the addressing mode in heart?
Immediate.
Implicit.
Because the code is complete in itself. Okay. Now our next instruction is third instruction, that is out 8-bit port address. Okay. Now what is the IWS for this instruction?
Two byte.
What is the IWS for this instruction? Out 8-bit port address.
1 byte, sir.
Why this is 1 byte? And why this is 2 byte?
One for out instruction and one for 8-bit data.
Right. 1 byte for this out instruction and 1 byte for 8-bit port address. Basically, for with this instruction out, we access 8-bit port address. For example, 0204. Okay. If you want to access our data, which is available in accumulator, and we want to access this that data at the output port of the processor, in that case we have to use the addressing of that port. So for this purpose we have an instruction that is out 8-bit port address. Okay, it's a 2-byte instruction. 1 byte for 8-bit address, port address, and the 1 byte for opcode. Right. Now what is the function at port address? Content of accumulator, you can note down, content of accumulator is available at port address. Are you getting my point? Are you getting? Same instruction is for data in. Fourth instruction is in 8-bit address. Why What is the IWS for this instruction? Tell me.
2 byte.
I'm writing the function of this instruction. Data available at port address will be in accumulator, right? Suppose if we have any data at port address and we want to access that data in accumulator, in that case we will use this instruction in 8-bit port address. We define address here of the port where data is available and we want to input it into accumulator. For that case we will use in 8-bit address or in 8-bit port address instruction. What is the IWS for this instruction?
2 bytes, sir.
Right, 2 bytes. Okay. So these are the 4 8-bit data transfer instruction. Now we are moving toward the next type. We have a 2-machine instruction. Two machine instruction. And I have underlined it. First instruction is NOP. What is the name of this function, this instruction?
No operation.
Very good. NOP instruction means no operation. Exactly. This is the right answer. What is the IWS for this instruction?
1 byte.
1 byte, sir.
Think once again and then tell me the answer. You have 20 seconds for the answer. Can you give me the answer? Am I audible? Am I audible?
Yes.
What is the IWS for this instruction?
1 byte.
Exactly, 1 byte. Okay, you can note it down. Function in execution of NOP instruction, no operation is performed, and this is a very important note from the perspective of GATE, NET, and other competitive exam. NOP is used to create delay. Second machine instruction is, please try to note everything which we are discussing here. Second machine instruction is halt. This is again of 1 byte instruction. And function of halt is, after execution of this instruction, the program counter will terminate, or you can say PC increment is stopped. I'm writing here in short, PC increment is stopped. Right? So this is all about HART and what is addressing mode in this instruction?
Implicit.
What you are addressing mode in? No?
Implicit.
Okay. So this is all about 8-bit data transfer instructions. Okay. If you have any doubt, you can ask me better. Otherwise, we are stopping our class here because few students are not, don't join today's class. Actually, if you have any doubt, you can ask.
Sir, in last class, you have discussed about 8085 instructions, sir.
Yes.
Sir, in which, sir, bitwise and machine wala, sir, samajh mein nahi aaya tha.
Okay. We will discuss your problem in our after 2 and 3 classes. Okay. Let's have some more instructions. Okay. Only then you will be able to understand the concept. Right. Okay. Tomorrow.
Okay, sir.
We will discuss some more arithmetic instructions of 8085 microprocessor. Right.
Yes, sir.
Okay.